I can do what it says I can do. I can have what it says I can have. That's why I'm going to read it. That's why I'm going to live it. That's why I'm going to tell everybody. Just like I'm telling you right now. I got to tell it on the mountaintop. I got to tell it in the Babylon. I got to tell it everywhere I go. That Jesus saved. Jesus saved. Jesus saved. And he delivers and baptized with the Holy Ghost. Somebody shout yes. Yes, and so we find out that Peter, while he was there, he preached the word of God, and the word of God did not fall on deaf ears, because King Cornelius had his kinsmen and family members had all gathered up to hear from the Lord. That's what God would do. God had them all gathered up, and Peter had a great big platform to preach the gospel, and while he preached the gospel, the Holy Ghost fell on Cornelius and his household, just like on the day of Pentecost. Somebody shout hallelujah. There is no secret what God will do. What he's done for others, he will do for you. He is a great God. He is a wonderful God. He is a loving and a kind God. And I bless his name forevermore, because God knew exactly what Cornelius needed. And so does God know exactly what you need? Yes, can I get a witness from the daddies? Yes, can I get a witness from the mothers? Yes. Can I get a witness from the brothers and sisters? Yes. The Lord knows exactly what you need. Yes. And the Holy Ghost fell on Cornelius and his household. And they were filled by the power of the Holy Ghost. And they began to do things like Peter saw on the day of Pentecost. And he had to recognize and realize that God is no respecter of persons. If he touched the Jew, he'll touch the Gentile. He'll touch anybody that seeks after him. Have you touched him today? Have you sought him today? Have you said, Lord, fill my cup, Lord. Lord, touch my life, Lord. Lord, do great things in my life. Hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want you to know that's the kind of God that we serve.
Yeah.
He's a great God. Blessings and glory and wisdom and power and majesty and might and dominion belongs to our God.
Yeah.
Because my God is a great God.
Yes,
he sits high,
yeah,
but he looks low.
Yeah.
His eyes are upon me,
yeah,
and his ears are open to my prayers.
Yeah.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Yeah.
And get down on my knees and say, Lord, have mercy, please.
Oh, yeah.
We'll hear from heaven. He'll call, come all the way down. Reach down, pick me up and turn me around. If necessary, he'll open doors that will close in your face. And he'll close doors that, amen, were open. Somebody shout hallelujah. He'll make a way for you. He'll make a way for me. He's done it before. And he'll do it again. Why? Because Jesus had made it that way 2,000 years ago. You know the story. They hung him high and they stretched him wide. He died, but he rose again on the third day with power, all power in heaven and earth in his hand. And that power is resonant today. The power to deliver you from every evil way of the enemy. The power of God will help you in every circumstance.
Yeah.
Somebody shout yes. It will help you. It will deliver you. It will make a way out of no way. I'm so glad about what God did for Cornelius. And what God did for Cornelius, amen, opened the door for every other Gentile that will come on after him. And now I want you to understand what God did for Cornelius. He did it in our life. And the Bible says there is now no Hebrew or Greek. There is no male or female. There's no bond of free. But we are all one in Jesus Christ. One for all and all for one. Jesus, the head of the pack. Somebody shout hallelujah. Jesus.
Yes, sir.
The lily of the valley. Jesus. The bright of the morning star. Jesus. The sweet rose of Sharon. Jesus. My way out of no way. Jesus. My bridge over troubled water. Jesus. The Lord of glory. Jesus. The hope of glory. Jesus. My everything.
Yes, sir.
Is he your everything today?
Yeah.
Set on your feet today.
Yeah.
He's my everything.